Early 2020, the coronavirus is ravaging Italy. The first countries close their borders. Soon the whole of Europe will be under lockdown. It's the beginning of the so-called new normal. The Dutch immunologist Hans Clevers knows how dangerous a contagious virus like SARS-CoV-2 can be. Yet even he is surprised at just how quickly everything changes.
There's a huge lockup in the institute, the whole country closed down, and everybody's lives changed dramatically. I don't think people had really seen this coming. Even the scientists who had seen previous coronaviruses had expected this.
Hans Clevers responds to the new threat like many others. He thinks about what contribution he can make in the fight against COVID-19. And he has an idea. Could the high death rates be related to the virus attacking not only the lungs, but other organs too?
There were multiple small reports that people would be vomiting or would have diarrhea, would have stomach aches. There were some reports that people found traces of the virus in feces or in on anal swabs, as it's called, not only in nasal swabs.
Clevers decides to get to the bottom of things. The biggest challenge, the research has to be fast so that people can benefit from the results as soon as possible. Fortunately, Clevers already knows a method that could solve the riddle. He wants to unleash the virus onto so-called organoids. Human organs in miniature format.
Almost every organ in our body has the capacity to replace cells that are lost, that are either just old and discarded or that underwent some disease process and were lost. And this is done by stem cells, so every tissue has stem cells. And we invented about 10, 12 years ago a method to isolate these stem cells from individual organs. And when we put those stem cells in a plastic dish, together with a defined set of growth vectors and substances like vitamins and minerals and proteins and things like that, we could encourage these stem cells to multiply. And in fact, and that was a big surprise, they just don't make many stem cells, they make little organs.
Organoids are fascinating structures. Clevers is one of their inventors. In the first step, researchers take a tissue sample from a patient or test subject, usually from the organ from which an organoid is later to grow. In the next step, they isolate the so-called stem cells and make them divide. Miniature versions of organs begin to grow. Mini intestines, hearts, and kidneys. Perfect test objects to investigate whether the coronavirus affects other human organs in addition to the lungs.
I emailed a good friend who heads the virology department at Rotterdam at Erasmus and proposed, well, shall we do an experiment together? Because we can grow human organs. You have the virus, you know how to show the virus. Can we collaborate?
In a high security laboratory, the researchers infect a mini intestine with SARS-CoV-2 viruses and leave the sample alone for a day. With the aid of a complicated process, they then create images in which the virus can be seen in orange. The result is terrifying.
We added essentially one virus per cell, and then within a day you saw that there were many, many more viruses, and in 3 days there was a massive amount of virus, meaning that the virus indeed went in a cell, infected that cell, reprogrammed the cell, and then that cell stops being itself, it just makes more copies of the virus.
The virus actually spreads inside the organoid. Proof that COVID-19 not only infects the lungs. At the beginning of May, the researchers published the result in the journal Science. Only 6 weeks passed from the initial idea to the final study.
We provided a piece of a puzzle, of a very large puzzle. And while it is something I want to stress, it's amazing that a virus that was entirely unknown in December, when these first patients started appearing, that it was actually found out that it was the cause of the, within weeks, the sequence of the DNA, the genetic code, was resolved in a matter of a week or so. It was immediately put out on internet. And that's when other people started looking at this. So the sheer amount of data that are being generated by scientists is incredible. I've never seen anything like it.
All over the world, scientists like Hans Clevers are working hard to lead us out of the corona crisis. To defeat the virus, they're working together more closely than ever before.